sometimes used to make a diagnosis. However, our next guest says your blood test could be failing you and keeping you from figuring out the underlying cause of your symptoms. Here to explain, welcome back Dr. David Sheridan with HOTSI Health and Wellness Center. All right, the blood test. You know, some people rely strictly on that test in front of them, but a lot of doctors I know at the HOTSI Health and Wellness Center, what you all say is we need to hear you as well.
You've got to go by symptoms. I think one of the biggest problems we have today is we look at all blood tests the same. Some blood tests come with a medical range where you and I may go through the range naturally, and that's one thing, but hormones are not that type of range. Each individual has their own individual norm.
Yeah.
So when we get a range from the lab for thyroid, for instance, that's a population range. That's, it's like height or IQ and say normal is between here and here, but each of us has our own individual range.
Right, because I was presenting with every single symptom of hypothyroidism, but yet I had several doctors say to me, well, you're within the range. All right, let's go through 10 common health conditions that people are diagnosed with today that can be related to hormones. Fibromyalgia is one of them, kind of a relatively new diagnosis.
You know, we mentioned this at the break. Fibromyalgia, chronic fatigue syndrome, and chronic Epstein-Barr virus. Three new diagnoses that all cropped up in the early 80s. Three new diagnoses never before known to man, and it happened about 10 years after we really had a big shift in how we looked at thyroid. And we were trapped by the lab work. And we stopped using pork thyroid, started using synthetic, and now we have three new diagnoses. But look at the common symptoms. Fatigue, muscle aches, joint aches that go
brain
along.
Fog,
brain
yeah.
fog, difficulty concentrating.
Gaining weight, yeah.
Weight gain you can't explain, being cold.
Yeah, so all those things, we go back to hormones, because I think that's another mystery for a lot of people, too, is that we all have hormones. We all
Absolutely.
Have to have them.
Mm-hmm.
So when they start
yeah.
to diminish, for whatever reason, I know a lot of times with women, after having a baby, it might shift, or just aging for all of us. So the key is, instead of medicating your symptoms, to go back and restore the hormones.
If you go back and look at all of the symptoms, and it's not that every symptom has to be hormonal, but any symptom can be. So if you look at a symptom pattern and say, gosh, this fits a hypothyroid pattern.
Right.
I'm going back to the safety of hormones. You start low, you move it up slowly. As you start seeing symptoms drift away, you're getting proof of your diagnosis.
Yeah, the other thing I was dealing with that I couldn't explain was depression,
mm-hmm.
which is common with
very common
hormone.
With low thyroid. Sometimes even anxiety. You think low thyroid, you think things are running low and slow, but there are exceptions, and some people even get anxious as part of their low thyroid situation. But yeah, we see so many people coming in on antidepressants, which carry with them a black box warning. That's a dangerous drug,
yeah.
and so many of them are able to get off these things as you get the thyroid straight.
Right, and we know antidepressants have their place. Mm-hmm. However, if the answer is really the hormones, that's what you replace it with.
Treat the cause.
All right, IBS, which we're hearing so much more mm-hmm. about as well. How does that impact?
I think with, again, you're talking low and slow. You're talking a generalized dysfunction in a system. And I think a lot of folks, we're hearing now of IBS with constipation, and I think that's the low thyroid situation peeking through.
Yeah, and you know, mentioned earlier with migraines, how mm-hmm. progesterone mm-hmm. levels could really change how you deal with migraines. The muscle and joint pain, which is oftentimes related to fibromyalgia. Mm-hmm. Insomnia, that was the other thing. I was so super tired, but yet when I went home to go to sleep, I thought, okay, I can finally go to sleep. I couldn't sleep.
Yeah, that's interesting. The sleep centers in the brain have to become metabolically more active in order for you to sleep, in order for to suppress conscious activity. So here's a tissue that has to become metabolically more active. It's hypothyroid, it can't, and you lay awake. And it's not that you're wired. You just don't turn off.
Yeah, yeah. Then there's memory loss and then elevated cholesterol. Basically, with low hormones, you start to fall apart all across
well,
your body.
Every tissue in our body needs hormones to function properly. Your thyroid gland, your thyroid hormones, they govern your metabolic rate. That's the rate at which each tissue does what it's supposed to do. So again, it's not that every symptom must be hormonal, but gosh, any symptom can be.
Yeah. The thing that I found was very frustrating is not every doctor looks at it the same way, which is the reason why I kept being told, we're going to mm-hmm. give you this for your weight gain, we're going to give you this for depression, we're going to give you this for that. So how do you get the right diagnosis if the blood test alone is not going to do it?
You've got to find someone who listens to symptoms. You know, when I was trained, in the 80s, and I was trained by an old ER doc that said, if you can't go out in the desert without a stethoscope and listen to symptoms, and practice good medicine, you shouldn't be here. Mm. History is that important.
Yeah, yeah. And then, of course, when we come to biomedical stuff and and then also dealing with an individual, like the amount that I might need might be different than the amount that somebody
individual
else needs.
Individual variability. Everybody's different. And again, that's the key with the blood levels and the ranges, is that it's not a medical range, it's a population range. This just says that humans, for a free T4 level, mostly fall between 1 and 2. Yeah. But I might need to be at 1.6 and you might need to be at 1.4.
So we can have something compounded just for us. All right. Well, everyone in today's studio audience is going home with Dr. Hotze's new book, Hypothyroidism, Health and Happiness. If you'd like to order a copy, just visit thyroidanswer.com/GDH. You can also join Hotze Health and Wellness for their Natural Health Summit beginning Tuesday, October 7th. This four-day online event will feature video presentations from the leading natural health experts on various topics ranging from detoxification to hormones, fitness, and more. The summit is free, but you must register. To do so, visit the banner on the homepage of HotzeHWC.com. You can get a lot of your questions answered. And for more information on Hotze Health and Wellness Center, you call 888-473-5531, 888-473-5531, and get your life back.